Good morning, family, friends, and visitors of Wesley Chapel United Methodist Church in McDonough, Georgia. In the name of Jesus Christ, we welcome you to our online worship service. On Sundays at Wesley Chapel, there are teleconference services at 8 and 9:45 a.m. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and watch our online service here at 10:30, or simply log on to Facebook or the Wesley Chapel website to view at your leisure. Also, on the third Sunday of every month, we have a drive-in service at 10:30 a.m. where you come as you are and stay in your car. Mark your calendars and save the date for a special time next month when we'll celebrate our church anniversary. But for just this special day, we're moving the drive-in service to the fourth Sunday, February 28th, still at 10:30 a.m. However you choose to worship, we're so glad you're joining us today. Now, here's what's happening in the church and around the community. While the coronavirus pandemic continues to plague our church and the community, our priority is the health and safety of all Wesley Chapel members, staff, and visitors. The church office will reopen tomorrow, February 1st at 9 a.m. Appointments will continue to be needed for all business on site, so call or email the church office to set an appointment. Anyone with business in the building or on the church grounds will be asked to fill out a contact tracing form, have their temperature checked, and be required to wear a mask at all times while at the church. All meetings and classes will remain virtual via Zoom and teleconferences. Please check your Wesley email for all of our COVID-19 safety protocols. Sunday school teleconference classes are held every Sunday for all ages. The adult class is at 8:45 a.m. The Junior Way class for students in grades 3 through 6 is at 11:30 a.m. And Youth Sunday School for students in grades 7 through 12 is at 12:30 p.m. Dial in to the Wesley Prayer Line, formerly called Corporate Prayer, on Mondays at 6 a.m. or 8 p.m. as our prayer warriors will start or close out your day praying for and with you. Throughout the week, there are several teleconference Bible studies to choose from. On Tuesdays, you're invited to traditional Bible study at 6:30 p.m. or the On the Mainline class at 7 p.m. On Wednesdays, for those who like to see the sunrise, Reverend Vicki Wansley teaches the Early I Seek Thee class at 6 a.m. And our senior pastor, Reverend Dr. William Bert Neal III, teaches the midday Bible study at noon. At Wesley Chapel, there are 5 ways to give your tithes and offerings. First, you can drive by and use the drop box outside under the canopy by the church office entrance. Secondly, you can give online at wesleymcd.org and click on the giving link. Third is by traditional U.S. mail to P.O. Box 1146, McDonough, Georgia 30253. Fourth is text to give at 770-954-8169. And fifth is through the Give Plus mobile app, which is a free download on Google Play or the Apple App Store. And now, our senior pastor, Reverend Dr. William Bert Neal III, will bring you greetings and prepare us for today's message.
Hello, my friends. Hello, family. My brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to Wesley Chapel United Methodist Church. This is our online worship experience on YouTube. I am Pastor William Bert Neal, and we are so glad you could join us today. We pray that you and your family are healthy, happy, and whole. We also pray that you would subscribe to our channel and take time to worship with us every Sunday. If this is your first time, then welcome. We're glad you're here and pray that you will enjoy the music, the prayers, the videos, and the message of our worship experience. And come back again next Sunday. We are currently not able to worship together. As much as we would like to be with each other in person, your safety is foremost in our hearts and prayers. We are forever grateful that God has provided this virtual way for us to stay connected with each other. Praise his holy name and hear a word from God. One day we will worship again in person, and on that day we want you to simply come and worship and praise the Lord with us. We will be sure to let you know the day and time to be here. We believe that Wesley Chapel is a warm and welcoming fellowship of believers. We would love to meet you and want you to know that whenever you have the opportunity to be with us, you will be welcomed and we will be grateful. I believe you would enjoy getting to know us and faithfully grow with us. Follow us on Facebook, Wesley Chapel United Methodist Church. We are located at 397 Racetrack Road, McDonough, Georgia. First and always, giving honor to God, our Creator, for it is in God that we live and move and have our very being. Giving honor to his Son, my Lord and Savior, for there is only one name given under heaven and earth by which we can be saved, and that is the name of Jesus Christ. And giving honor to the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, the Comforter, the Guide and Teacher, an ever-present help in time of trouble. As always, I give honor to my wife, Denise, flesh of my flesh and bone of my bone, the butter on my biscuit, the honey in my tea, and the pepperoni on my pizza. It is the fifth Sunday in January 2021. Can you believe it? A month has already passed in the new year. You have already heard this week's church and community announcements. You know, last year during the political season, I took the opportunity to place some pastoral emphasis on sharing updates about the elections and or other important political information to share with our beloved community so that you would be an informed citizen. Now, I know that there are lots of issues in the news these days, from the Biden administration attempting to get cabinet appointments approved, to the impeachment trial, to the third stimulus check being approved, to schools reopening. There's always a lot of things to consider that impact our daily lives. But for right now, I consider the most pressing issue of our day to be the coronavirus vaccine. I understand the apprehensions that we as African Americans have when it comes to trust in medical research trials and practices. In our community, it is hard to overcome a deep-rooted skepticism that is the result of historical mistreatment of Black Americans by the medical industry. However, there have already been several trusted messengers and trusted opinions from leaders and institutions in our community that ensure confidence about receiving the vaccine. A series of prominent Black leaders have publicized the shots they have received in hopes of boosting vaccine acceptance in the Black and brown communities. The CEO of Howard University, Anita Jenkins, said, and I quote, "I understand there is a lot of hesitancy in minority communities across the country when it comes to health care, but this is not an American experiment on Black people. The vaccine is a worldwide cure to end a global pandemic and set us on a path back to normalcy." Morehouse School of Medicine President Valerie Montgomery Rice said she would not recommend this vaccine if she did not believe it was safe. There has been a lot of work in the process of ensuring the safety and viability of the vaccine from other Black medical institutions like Charles R. Drew University of Medicine and Science, Meharry Medical College, the National Black Nurses Association, and the National Medical Association, a professional society of African American doctors. I'm confident that they have operated in the best interest of all of us. So I will be taking the vaccine as soon as the supply is made available for me and my family. The challenge of getting the vaccine is prevalent all across the country. Depending on vaccine allocations from the federal government supplying the states, it may be weeks before additional providers will have the vaccine available for quicker and more widespread distribution. I am prayerful, and I hope you are too, that as more vaccines become available, that the process for making an appointment and getting the vaccine will improve. As a pastor, I plan to use some of our time each Sunday for pastoral emphasis to keep you informed as much as possible about the vaccine, from what to expect, safety, side effects, fertility, pregnancy, how the vaccine works, and what happens after the vaccine, locations to receive it, eligibility, and any information to help you make an informed decision for you and your family. In your search for a COVID vaccine site in your area, be sure to check online often, as the list of locations for vaccinations is frequently updated. Additional locations statewide will be added when providers are ready to safely administer vaccine and as vaccine supply allows. I encourage you to go to the CDC website, which is cdc.gov/coronavirus for updates. There you will find answers to an assortment of questions about coronavirus, as well as 8 things you need to know about the COVID-19 vaccine program. The Georgia Department of Public Health website is also another good reference site for information. That website address is dph.georgia.gov/covid-vaccine. That website has a vaccine locator and a Georgia COVID-19 vaccine hotline. Here at Wesley Chapel, we've instituted a policy that requires everyone entering the church to complete a contact tracing form and have their temperature taken. As the church office reopens on February 1st, please note that you must make an appointment to come to the church for all church business. All our meetings, classes, Bible studies, and worship experiences will be virtual for the foreseeable future. Even if you have had the vaccine or tested negative for coronavirus, you still need to remember the 4 W's. Wear a mask, wash your hands, watch your distance, and wait on gathering. Please, my friends, stay away from large gatherings until this virus is under better control. As more information becomes available, we'll be sure to include it on our website, in email blast, and our weekly Wisdom from Wesley email. Let us continue to trust in God and be in prayer for each other. Now, let's invite Minister Adra Smith to lead us in prayer, and then have Reverend Vicki Wansley lead us in praise and through the rest of this service. God bless.
Good morning, Wesley, and happy Sunday to you. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will be glad and rejoice in this day. For I was glad when they said unto me, let's go to the house of the Lord. So with that being said, let us go to God in prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, as we come to you today, Lord God, approaching the throne of grace boldly, without doubt, fear, or condemnation, Lord, we thank you, for this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will be glad and rejoice in this day, Father. We thank you, Father God, in this day for life. We thank you, Father God, in this day for health and strength, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We just thank you and we praise you, Lord God. If we had 10,000 tongues, Lord God, we could not praise you enough, Lord God, for allowing us to see this day, for allowing us to be in our right minds, Lord God, for our bodies to be functioning the way you have ordained for them to function, Lord God. For that, God, we give you thanks. We give you praise, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, for being Almighty God in our life. We thank you, Father God, for being El Shaddai, the God that's more than enough. And besides you, Lord God, there is no other. We thank you for being Jehovah Shalom, the God of our peace. In the midst of every situation, in the midst of every storm, every trial, every tribulation, we thank you for being our peace in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father God, for the joy of the Lord being our peace in the midst of everything that we're going through, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father God, for being Jehovah Jireh, our provider, God, the God that sees our needs and provide for us, Lord God, because your word tells us, Lord God, that I never seen the righteous forsaken, nor their seed begging bread, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father God, for being Jehovah Rapha in our life, the Lord God that heals us from all sickness, illnesses, diseases, and infirmities in the name of Jesus. We just thank you and we'll praise you, Lord God. We thank you, Father God, for the word that we're going to come forward today, God. We pray, Father God, that our ears be open to hear your word and our hearts be open to receive your word, Father, and that it would deliver us, change us, and set us free, Lord God, from anything, Lord God, that will cause us to be bound up, Father. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, we praise you, Lord God, that your word will fall on good ground, God, and that it will produce forth of harvest, Father, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, we praise you, Lord God. We love you, Father, and we give you all the glory, Father. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Thank you, Minister Adria, for that soul-inspiring prayer. We thank God for you. As we transition from prayer to praise, listen to Psalm 100. Shout triumphantly to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with celebration. Come before him with shouts of joy. Know that the Lord is God. He made us. We belong to him. We are his people, the sheep of his own pasture. Enter his gates with thanks. Enter his courtyards with praise. Thank him, bless his name, because the Lord is good. His loyal love lasts forever. His faithfulness lasts generation after generation. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And now think about all the things God has done for you. I invite you to praise the Lord with me. The sacrifice of our praise is simply the fruit of our lips giving thanks to his name. So we enter this service with praise and thanks. I can't tell you how to praise God. Just praise God the way you want to praise him. Let's thank the Lord for all that he's done for us. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for waking us up this morning. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the ability to move and have our being in you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for shelter, food, and clothes. We just want to thank you, Lord, for all you've done for us. Thank you, Lord. You've been so good to us. Thank you, Lord. You've made a way out of no way. Thank you, Lord. We belong to you. We are your people, the sheep of your own pasture. We bless you, Lord, because your love is everlasting and great is thy faithfulness. Thank you, Lord. Your faithfulness lasts from generation to generation. Lord God, we bless you. We bless your name and we praise you. Thank you, Lord, for redeeming us. Thank you, Lord, for forgiving us our sins and transforming us, God, for shining your gracious light all around us. Thank you, Lord, for never leaving us and never forsaking us. We will always give you all the glory, all of the praise, and all of the honor. Lord, we thank you and we bless your name. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen. One of our ministers is bringing the message today. Let me introduce to some of you who are viewing and present to others, Reverend Robert Morris. He serves on our ministerial team. He's a very critical member. He regularly participates in our worship and pulpit rotation, providing the invocation, pastoral prayer, and preaching. Rob was instrumental in organizing our foster care ministry with information sessions and foster care training. All this was done in conjunction with United Methodist Children Home. Reverend Morris is also one of our adult Sunday school facilitators, and he often facilitates some of our confirmation classes as needed. Rob received a Bachelor of Arts degree in Child Development from Morehouse College. He went on to receive a Master of Divinity degree from the Interdenominational Theological Center in Atlanta. And last year, he completed a Master of Family Therapy degree from Mercer University. Reverend Morris is currently a chaplain for Compassus Hospice and has served with them for the last 12 years. Reverend Morris has been very instrumental in assisting families and our church in handling personal griefs and losses. We have truly been blessed at Wesley Chapel with his gifts and servant heart. He is a man after God's own heart who lives up to the highest ideals of church and society. We have truly been blessed to be in ministry with him for the past 3 years. Now join me as we hear a word from Reverend Robert Morris on how to pray and hear his example of prayers and how to apply these prayers to our lives.
We thank God for this day and for this time of worship and the word. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, you will find these words. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for each of you. I want to speak to you briefly and engage you on the topic of prayer today. The Word of God admonishes us to pray without ceasing. What does this mean? Who can do that? Does this refer to a continual act of prayer in which we are to persevere until we obtain, or to the spirit of prayerfulness that should animate us all day long? Christ gave us an example of a life of prayer, a posture of prayer. If we think about a branch of a tree, it is only when the branch gives itself to bear fruit that it can live a healthy and rich life with an inflow, with a constant flow. Prayer, my brothers and sisters, keeps us in God's presence always, brings to our awareness of being in the presence of God. It helps us to stay grounded amidst the twists and turns that life can take. Remember that our sufficiency lies in God, and prayer reminds us of that. Every child of God has the Holy Spirit living inside them and equips them with the ability to pray. Prayer is one of our most powerful tools as believers and as children of God. And we should use it and access it as often as possible. During this message today, I'm going to uplift a series of prayers that I hope will help to reiterate and reinforce the power that we obtain when we pray. How should we pray? Pray as the Holy Spirit leads you. Pray from your authentic being. Pray from a place of being true to who you are. You confessed faith in God. Pray from that space. We know that the Spirit leads us to pray. The Spirit intercedes on our behalf with groanings that are too deep for words. And that's Romans 8 and 26. Let us pray. God, we need your guidance because we hardly know where to begin sometimes, let alone what to say or how to say it. Even when we have no special requests, we just want to thank you for all your blessings. When we struggle to find the words, oh God, we are thankful for your Holy Spirit who knows exactly what to say and intercedes on our behalf. Thank you, God. In our own power, we cannot walk in your statutes. Our hearts and minds wander into places they have no business going. Fill us with your Spirit so that we may glorify you in every choice that we make. Give us strength to obey you completely, so each second of our day will be filled with little testimonials of your goodness. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The next way we can pray is praying in confident expectation. Pray in confident expectation. Jeremiah 33 calls us to pray with expectation. God says, call unto me and I will answer thee, and I will show you great and mighty things. God has a plan for each of us. In order for us to live out that plan, it is imperative that we go to God and seek God so that we can walk in God's plan for our lives. Let us pray. God, sometimes our faith is strong. Be with us on those days when it's strong and on the days when our faith may be weak. We seek you, O God. What we do not see today, we realize that you may provide it at some other time. Help me to seek you in faith for all of my needs, Almighty God. And let me reach out to those who do not yet believe in you. Help us to know that the little faith that we have will bring someone else to you, O God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. When we pray, brothers and sisters, we should pray with our whole heart. We ought to bring our whole selves to our prayer. Open up our heart. God knows what we need and God knows what's in our heart. But there's something about pouring out your heart to the Lord that makes for a more intimate relationship. It makes for a more intimate communion with God. So open up your heart to God today and be honest. David said, I will have fainted unless I believe to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Open up your heart. Pray your heart. God listens to every petition with God's whole heart. So every time we pray, the whole infinite God is there to hear us. God desires for us to bring our whole selves to him in prayer. Let us pray. Gracious God, we know you give power to those who are faint and to them who have no might. You increase their strength. Though you were able to do powerful things that cannot be explained, we ask that you reveal to us, O God, our hidden strengths, that strength that we didn't even realize we had, O God. Reveal to us those capabilities, O God, that we can use for your kingdom and to bless those who are around us. We thank you, God, for giving us boldness and courage, O God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. My brothers and sisters, I want to remind you today that when we pray individually, when we pray collectively, when we pray as a body, pray as the Spirit leads you. Not in some form or fashion, not imitating or emulating someone else, but pray as the Spirit leads you. Pray in confidence to God, expecting God to do what it is that you're asking God to do. Pray in faith. All it takes is faith, the grain of a little mustard seed. Pray in faith and pray with your whole heart. Pour your whole heart out to God and be honest with God about where you are. Be honest with God about what you want God to do. Be honest to God about your challenges, about your struggles. casting all your cares on God, for God cares for you when we pray. God bless you, God keep you, and God continue to smile upon you. In this time that we live in, it is so imperative that we remain grounded as believers, that we remain focused, that we continue to trust and hold on to God's unchanging hand. Prayer is the most important way for us to do that. Prayer is the most important thing that we can do to continue to be strong and press forward. Paul says, I press forward. I press towards the mark of the prize of the high calling, which is in Christ Jesus. So let us pray. In the Spirit, let us pray in faith, expecting, and let us pray with our whole heart. Holy and perfect God, we want to be more available to you. Help us desire to sink deeply enough into our being and to say no to at least one worthy but not urgent task today. Give us the grace that we need during these times to respond with patience, trust, and acceptance, to listen carefully, to reach out to one another in peace. Help us to be fair and just, to anticipate the goodness that you have for us in all of our words and deeds. God, you are more than we can ever comprehend. Help us to seek you and you alone. Help us to place before you all that we could do and seek what you would do and do that thing. Lift from us our need to achieve all that we can be and instead surrender to what you can be in us. Give us ways to refrain from the busyness that will put us on edge and off center. And give us today your peace. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Rob, for that inspiring message from on high. You shared with us the importance of prayer, and you reminded us that prayer keeps us in God's presence. In times like these, we can internalize these nuggets from your message. To pray as the Holy Spirit leads us, to pray in confident expectation, and to pray with our whole heart. Surely, there is power in praying to God, because nothing is too hard for our God. Thank you again, Reverend Rob. During our virtual worship, we're mindful that someone viewing today's service may want to receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of your life. Or perhaps you believe in Christ, but you strayed from a path of righteousness and personal discipleship. Or maybe you simply want to renew yourself in Christ today. Wherever you are, I want you to pray this prayer with me. Heavenly Father, have mercy on me, a sinner. I believe in you and that your word is true. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God and that he died on the cross so that I may have forgiveness for my sins and eternal life. I know that without you in my heart, my life is meaningless. I believe in my heart that you, Lord God, raised Jesus from the dead. Please, Lord, forgive me and come into my heart as my personal Lord and Savior today. I accept, confess, and proclaim Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior, to live in my heart from this day forward. Thank you, Jesus, for your grace that has saved me from my sins and has given me eternal life. Please send your Holy Spirit to guide me and help me to do your will for the rest of my life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. I invite you to call our Ministry Connect line at 678-709-1254. We want to pray with you and for you. And we want you to stay connected to Christ and His church. Reach out today and we will reach right back to you. Call our Ministry Connect line today at 678-709-1254. We thank you, Anita, Minister Adra, Pastor Neil, and Reverend Morris for your service and witness in our worship service today. May God continue to bless you and keep you in His grace. And God, please bless all who are watching our online worship service today. Now receive this benediction. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Now go forward in peace.